The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. Guys, you know we make videos about health and healthcare topics and all our videos are directly referenced from the US National Medical Library. And on your request, persistent request, today I'm going to make a video on lactose intolerance. So what is this? See, lactose is a type of sugar which is found in milk and other dairy products, right? There is an enzyme which is called lactase, which is needed by your body to digest this lactose. And lactose intolerance develops when the small intestine does not make enough of this enzyme, lactase. So why this happens? How to treat it? How to diagnose it? What are the symptoms? What is the test? Everything will be covered today in this video. So let's start. In a baby, right, a baby's body makes the lactase enzyme so they can actually digest milk very easily, including the breast milk of a mother. So babies born too early, that is premature babies, sometimes can have lactose intolerance, right? And children who were born at full term, often they do not show signs of the problem of this lactose intolerance before they are at least 3 years old, right? And lactose intolerance is very common in adults also, right? But it is rarely dangerous. It is common but not dangerous. In about a lot of people, they can actually have lactose intolerance by around 20 years of age, right? And the illness basically involves or injures your small intestine, right? That may, and the problem is in the small intestine, that means there is an injury or there is a problem in the intestine that it is not able to make the lactase enzyme, right? So you have to actually treat or improve the symptoms, and that is the treatment. But what is the problem? Where does this happen? See, what can happen if you have had, what are the reasons, what are the causes? Number one cause is surgery of the small intestine. If you ever had a surgery in small intestine or an infection in the small intestine, like in the children, infection in the small, everybody had stomach infections, right? Come on. So this is the most common reason in children, right? Surgery is the second most common reason. And then there are diseases which can actually damage the small intestine, like celiac disease, celiac spur, or Crohn's disease, right? So these are the most common reasons why you can have lactose intolerance, or you might even have this problem congenitally from birth when a baby is born with a genetic defect that they cannot make lactase enzyme. So either it is from birth or in your life you had something which damaged your intestines, right? So what happens if you are lactose intolerant and you had something of a milk product, you ingested it, then what happens? After 30 minutes to 2 hours of taking a milk, you will have symptoms. Symptoms can be mild to worse, and it will increase on the basis of the amount of milk. Symptoms can be from abdominal bloating, abdominal cramps, diarrhea. It can be gas, flatulence, or nausea. Remember, right, every time you have a gastroenteritis, an infection of the abdomen, at that time your intestines will not produce the required amount of lactase enzyme, and at that time you won't be able to digest milk. Many people suffer with this problem. Many people have this. Only a few people may just be able to digest milk, even in a disease, in the intestinal disease, right? So how will we diagnose it? See, when you go to a doctor, the doctor will first try to diagnose other problems which can present in this condition, like irritable bowel syndrome. And even they will do some tests, right? What kind of tests? There are three tests which are available. One is lactose hydrogen breath test. Second is lactose tolerance test. And third is a stool pH test. So these three tests can help us determine if you have lactose intolerance or not. Then what is the treatment? See, the treatment is to cut down your intake of milk products that can that basically contain lactose, and you can actually get relief by just doing that, right? So you also have to read the food labels, because in many products there can be hidden sources of lactose, even in non-milk products, right? Including some beers, right? So you can avoid them also. Most people with a low lactase level can even drink up to 1 cup of milk at a time, right? So 1 cup of milk at a time, and they might not have any symptoms. A large serving of like 240 ml, 250 ml may cause problems, for the people who have this kind of mild low levels deficiency. So what are the milk products that may be easier to digest in this kind of a condition, right? You might be able to digest buttermilk and cheese. These foods basically contain less amount of lactose as compared to milk. Fermented milk products like yogurt can be easily digested. Goat's milk has less amount of lactose. Hard cheese is also like that. Lactose free milk or milk products are available in the market, or even lactase treated milk, cow's milks are also there for children as well as older adults. Soy formulations are there for infants and even adults. Soy or rice milks are there. Rice milk is also there. And there is one more solution. You can even add the lactase enzyme to regular milk or take lactase tablets. You can also take these as capsules. Chewable tablets are also available. And there are also many lactase free dairy products available. Right. See, not having milk and dairy products in your diet can lead to a shortage of various nutrients like calcium, vitamin D, riboflavin, proteins. So you need at least 1000 to 1500 milligram of calcium each day, depending upon your age and gender. And therefore, you need to do something to get more calcium if you're not taking milk. Right. So you need to take either a calcium supplement with vitamin D. So you can talk to your doctor for that. Or you need to eat foods that have more calcium, like green leafy vegetables. You can eat fishes, oysters, sardines, shrimp, broccoli. These things have more calcium. And you can drink orange juice with added calcium. That is also there. So what is the prognosis? See, symptoms most often go away when you remove milk and other dairy products from your diet, right? And without dietary changes, infants or children will also have growth problems. So if you don't change this, and your child has a problem, then proper digestion, nutritional deficiency will develop, right? And growth problems can occur. So if you have any kind of symptoms similar to this, when you drink milk, if your child is not growing properly or growing slowly, if your child has symptoms like this, if they are getting worse and not getting relieved by treatment, then you should go to a doctor and get evaluated. Prevention, quite frankly, there is no known way to prevent lactose intolerance. You can prevent some of the symptoms by avoiding some foods with lactose, but then there is no straightforward prevention of this. This is all what we have about milk intolerance, right, and lactase deficiency. I hope this video is helpful. There is no permanent cure for this disease, but then you can slowly sensitize yourself by daily dosages of milk, so that you might be able to tolerate a little more amount slowly over a period of years. But that's a job to do, right? So that's all about lactose intolerance, lactase deficiency. Thank you so much for watching. Stay connected, stay healthy.